You issued over 24 million new shares of stock. And I want to know, how much were your shares diluted? How much were his?
Yeah.
I signed the papers, but you set me up, and now it's going to be like I'm not part of Facebook. Is this because I froze the account? Because you don't like my suits? Well, sorry. My prod is at the cleaners along with my hoodie and my fuck you flip-flops, you pretentious douchebag. I'm not signing those papers. You had me accused, and I'll bet what you hated the most is that they identified me as a co-founder of Facebook, which I am. So you better lawyer up, asshole. Because I'm not coming back for my 30%. I'm coming back for everything. I see everything. Most other people are lazy. They never look at everything. They do what is called glancing, which is the same word for bumping off something and carrying on in almost the same direction. And the information in their head is really simple. For example, if they're sitting on a train looking out onto the countryside, it might be looking out at a field that's full of grass. There are some cows in the field. There are some flowers in the grass. There's a village in the distance. And then they would stop noticing anything because they would be thinking about something else. But if I'm sitting on the train, looking out of the window onto the countryside, I notice everything. Like, there are 19 cows in the field, 15 of which are black and white, 4 of which are brown and white. There's a village in the distance which has 32 visible houses and a church with a square tower and a spire. There's a plastic bag from Tesco in the hedge with a squashed Coca-Cola can and a snail on it. I can see 3 different types of grass and 2 different colors of flowers in the grass. The cows are mostly facing uphill. And the hedge is moving to suggest there's a wind blowing from a northwesterly direction. And there's the Coca-Cola. And the snail. The cows are facing the snail. And there's a Boeing 747-400 and the snail. The snail.
She the chico, yo. Where you at? Where you been? Where you at? Where you at? Oh, hey.
book is Cletus.
It's from
Cletus?
It's girl. Ready for presser.
We have to wrap. 5, 6, 7, 8. Yo.
You're settled down, that you found a girl and you're married now. I heard that your dreams came true. Yes, she gave you things that I didn't give to you. Old friend, why are you so shy? Like you to hold back or hide from the light. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away. I couldn't fight it. I'd hoped you'd see my face and that you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over. Never mind, I'll fight someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, happy. I remember you say sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. You know how the time flies. Only yesterday was the time of our lives, and we were born and raised in a summer haze, bound by be surprised of our glory days. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away. I couldn't fight it. I'd hoped you'd see my face and that you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over. Never mind, someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, and babe, I'll remember you say. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Nothing compares, no worries or cares, regrets and mistakes that memories made. Who would have known how bittersweet this would taste? Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I beg. I'll remember you say. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you. Sometimes it hurts instead.
side, like everyone else. I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, but I was just kidding myself. My reverie moment, I start to replace. Cause now they're gone, all I hear are the words that I needed to say. When you hurt under the surface, like troubled water running cold. Well, time can heal, but this won't. So, before you go, was there something I could have said to make your heart beat better? If only I'd have known you had a storm to weather. So, before you go, was there something I could have said to make it all stop burning? It kills me how your mind can make you feel so worthless. So, never the right time, whenever you called. And little by little by little, until there was nothing at all. A reverie moment, I start to replay. Cause all I can think about is seeing that look on your face. When you hurt under the surface, like troubled water running cold. Well, time can heal, but this won't. Before you go, was there something I could have said to make your heart beat better? If only I'd have known you had a storm to weather. So, before you go, was there something I could have said to make it all stop hurting? It kills me how your mind can make you feel so worthless. So, before you go, will we be better off by now? If I'd let my walls come down, maybe I guess we'll never know. You know, you know.
Friends, I'm your Vitamita Vegemin girl. Are you tired, run down, listless? Do you poop out at parties? Are you unpopular? The answer to all your problems is in this little bottle.
Now you pick up the bottle. A little higher. That's right.
The answer to all your problems is in this little bottle. Vitamita Vegemin. Vitamita Vegemin contains vitamins, meat, vegetables, and minerals. Yes, with Vitamita Vegemin, you can spoon your way to health. All you do is take a tablespoonful after every meal.
Now you take some.
It's tasty too. Tastes just like candy.
No, no, no. Look, you're supposed to like this stuff. You gotta smile, be happy. Now try it again.
Okay. It's tasty too! Tastes just like candy!
Nope, once more.
It's tasty too! Tastes
That's going to be fine. Just go ahead.
So why don't you join the thousands of happy peppy people and get your great big bottle of Vitamita Vegemin tomorrow? That's Vitamita Vegemin.
Sure, I saw that sign. If I can read the fine print on our contract, I can certainly read words 2 feet off the ground. The mother of Miss Gypsy Rose Lee may not be backstage at this theater. You know what I did with that sign? I tore it off the wall and laid it on the floor and set Chowsey the Third down on it. That dog's a trooper. She knew exactly what to do. It'll take more than signs to keep me out of the theater.
That goes now.
You need something to remind you that your dream was to be a great actress, not a cheap stripper.
June's the actress, Mother. And I'm not a cheap stripper. I'm the highest paid in the business.
Aren't you taking a bath?
Yes, Mother.
Then why are you fixing your face?
A photographer's coming.
Where is he going to photograph you? The tub?
Eventually.
Louise!
It's for Vogue.
Louise! I'll go grab our scrapbooks.
Phil's already taking care of all that.
Phil? He's a rotten press agent. He never tells them the headline, The Orpheum Circuit.
Hello? Hello? No, it's difficult right now.
I'm not leaving.
Yes. Of course I'll be there. I'll be in chat.
I'll be in what?
I suppose I'm being a little much, but Mama, I love it.
Well, so who's throwing the party?
Some friends.
In the old days, I was always invited first. And I wouldn't even go, even if I did have something to wear. I'd always have more important things to do, like thinking up a new strip for us.
Mother, we're still stuck with that wind machine you bought me to blow off my clothes. Actually, I'm putting in a new number on Saturday.
What is it?
You'll see.
I'll see?
Let me surprise you.
These days, you're just one big surprise after another. We have to go dress shopping tomorrow to pick out material for the dress.
I've got a French lesson tomorrow.
Oh, well, I'll go alone. Any particular color you have in mind?
Mother, I've already started to make the gown.
Well, then let me run your back.
You don't have to. That's what the maid's for.
Let me do something, damn it!
What, Mother?
A million things. I'm not a baby.
Neither am I.
Don't get that edge in your voice. Your sister used to get that.
I am not June.
You're not Louise either.
Neither are you.
Oh, yes, I am. More than you, Miss Gypsy Rose Lee, with your dirty pictures for Vogue.
Mother.
And your maids, and your press agents, and your fancy friends, and their fancy
they
parties.
They happen to be.
They and your mother isn't invited, because they'll laugh at her.
They don't.
They do. And don't think that's one reason why you don't want me backstage, because you don't want me to hear them laugh. Well, I'll tell you, it's them you gotta keep out, not me. Because they laugh at you too, you, the burlesque queen with your lousy French and reading book reviews like they was books.
Turn it off, Mother.
You know what you want of them? A circus freak. This year's a novelty act and the bill is changed.
I said turn it off. Nobody laughs at me because I laugh first at me. Me from Seattle. Me with no education, me with no talent, as you've kept reminding me my whole life. Well, look at me now. A star. Look at my friends. Look at how I live. Look where I'm going. I'm not staying in burlesque. I'm moving. Maybe up, maybe down. But wherever it is, I'm enjoying it. Mama, I'm enjoying my life because for the first time, it is my life. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna let you take that from me. I am Gypsy Rose Lee. I love her. And if you don't, you can clear out right now. Mama, we can't go shouting 7 performances of this a week.
Our whole family shouts. It comes from us living so near the railroad tracks.
Getting an ulcer.
You think I'm not?
Yes, I think you're not. And if you want an ulcer, Mama, get one of your own. You can't have mine.
Everyone has stomach troubles with me.
Mother, you fought your whole life. I wish you could just relax.
You need more mascara in your left eye.
Mama, you have got to let go of me.
Let go? You need me.
I'll give you anything you want. A house, a farm, a school, a dramatic school for kids. You were always so great with kids.
I am a pro, not just a horse you can turn out to pasture just because you're suddenly feeling like you're riding high on your own.
Mama, no kid does it on his own, but I am not a kid anymore. From now on, even if I flop on my own.
All right. Just one thing I need to know. All the working and practicing and pushing, all the scheming and scrimping and lying awake at night, wondering how we're gonna get from one town to the next, how we're all gonna eat on a buck, how am I gonna make an act out of nothing? You're saying I fought my whole life, I fought your whole life. So now tell me, what did I do it for?
I thought you did it for me, Mama.
Buffalo, New York. Buffalo is home to tons of wildlife and nature, from the fallow deer to the little squirrel. And you'd assume that actual buffalo would live here, but we don't have those, unless you count the zoo. Buffalo is one of the few places in the world that always likes to snow in the middle of spring. Yes, the middle of spring. For the most part, humans hate living here. But there is an exception. The animals truly love it. Meet Scrumpy, a tabby cat that just turned 2 years old. Weighing at 10 pounds, he's a cat that has realized he's about to embark on a massive journey. A cat's life is hard, living in an apartment in Buffalo, having to deal with laying around all the time, sleeping, soaking up the sunlight, and just being crazy. Some of the stuff I myself wish I had time for, but I unfortunately don't. But enough about me. This beautiful animal is also so very curious, which will get him in a lot of trouble. This species relies on its cuteness to get out of this trouble. On this journey, a cat will learn to live with a tortoise. Two animals that wouldn't normally live together in the wild will have to learn to cohabitate together. You may call this story The Tortoise and the Hare. You see what I did there? Yes, you, Scrumpy. Did you see? You may wonder why there's a tortoise living with a cat. And to be honest with you, I really don't know. But my girlfriend hates it. With her being allergic to Scrumpy, this also causes a challenge not just for the little cat, but for my own ass as well, because they both require lots of attention. But the little reptile that doesn't need as much attention other than an occasional shell scratch and a bath and some food, well, he's not a turtle, so first of all, make sure you guys understand he's not a turtle, he's a tortoise. If you throw this tortoise in water, he will drown, and it's just not pretty, it's not fun. People do it, and it's just really sad, and just as Jumba, the tortoise. Meet Chumba, the Russian tortoise. Being about the size of a McDonald's Big Mac, The world around him looks rather large. This beautiful little creature, his days consist of sunbathing, eating salad that I borrowed from Texas Roadhouse, digging in the dirt and sleeping way too much. Getting this cat and that tortoise, used to sharing a space and living as a family, has been quite difficult. But both the cat and the tortoise have been learning to come out of their shells and get along with living together in harmony. But Jumbo will mostly run away. Even though Scrumpy is just happy to have a brother and someone that he can play with and just have fun and cuddle. Jumbo the tortoise is not interested in all this playing. He would much rather be left alone with his salad and his house and all of his dirt. Scrumpy is very sad that he can't play. But the tortoise is learning to respect Scrumpy while Scrumpy respects the boundaries of what Jumbo likes and to be content with him living here. Scrumpy has realized that having a brother is a blessing, even though he is a tortoise, and is okay sharing the space with him, as long as he doesn't have to give up being the cutest one. Thank you for joining us, The Tortoise and the Hare.
Wait, so CBS News wants to interview you? How does that happen? I thought you said they were interviewing straight soldiers. Now they want to hear from the other side? Are you crazy? They'll kick you out. I don't care if your face is in shadow. It's humiliating. All the straight soldiers, the ones saying no fags in the military, they get to be out in the open, right? With their uniforms on, looking dignified. And you get to be in the shadows with your voice distorted like a criminal. The Navy, they are going to witch hunt you, Jeff, for sure. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter what precautions you take. Who cares what you have to say? You're not a general. You're not a war hero. You're an officer in the Navy, and it's not going to change. Nothing's going to change. I don't understand. I mean, look how they treated you. I believed in you, didn't I? When they certainly didn't. They don't want you. They never wanted you, Jeff, but I wanted you. You're a washed-up queer with a shitty job in a shitty condo bitching about how you could have been somebody. When I found you that night in the bar, I was there for you. I saved you. You're confused, you know that? You're confused and you can't even see it.
My name is Emily Carello, and this is a monologue from Postcards from the Edge by Carrie Fisher. This is hard. I feel like I've got bugs flying around inside of me. I talked to my friend Wallace today. I tried to get the operator to say, collect call from hell. Will you accept the charges? After not feeling anything for years, I'm having this feelings festival. The medication wears off and the feelings just fall on you. And they're not your basic fun feelings either. These are the feelings you've been trying specifically to avoid. And you almost killed yourself to avoid. The ones that say, you're something on the bottom of someone's shoe. And not even someone important. I talked to my agent today. I ended up in tears. Which is not my favorite presentation of myself, crying to my agent. I tried very hard not to, but I didn't stand a chance. I've used up all of the not cry I was assigned at birth. Now it's crying time. To my mother briefly. I thought she'd be mad at me for messing up the great life that she'd given me. She was actually very sweet. She said a great thing. I told her I was miserable here. And she just goes, well, you were happy. As a child, I can prove it. I have films. What went wrong between what she gave me and how I took it?
There was a time when I flew higher, was a time the wild girl running free could be me. Now I see her feel the fire, now I know she needs me there to share. I'm nowhere. All these blank and tranquil years, seems they've dried up all my tears. And while she runs free and fast, seems my wild days are past. I miss the mountains, I miss the dizzy heights, all the manic magic days, and the dark depressing nights. I miss the mountains, I miss the highs and lows, all the climbing, all the falling, all the wild wind blows, stinging you with snow and soaking you with rain. I miss the mountains, I miss the pain. Mountains make you crazy, here it's safe and sound. My mind is somewhere hazy, my
my feet are on the ground. Everything is balanced here and on an even keel. Everything is perfect. Nothing's real. Nothing's real. And I miss the mountains. I miss the lonely climb. Wandering through the wilderness and spending all my time where the air is clear. Cuts you like a knife. I miss the mountains. I miss the mountains. I miss my life. I miss my
Thanksgiving is hard. You know, it's very nerve-wracking getting the family together. My mother didn't cook last year because she was so sick. Now I'm gonna have to deal with Gloria, who's not cooking, thank God. And my little brother, and my father, who insists that nothing has changed, even though the last couple of times I've seen him, he's gotten drunk and lost his temper. And I know in some way there's a chance that I'll just walk around the house from room to room in tears. But it is Thanksgiving, and I am grateful for things like this. This has helped. Dawn doesn't think so, but it has. Being able to talk, just you and me and your little pad. Still, I can't help but think that I'd be happy if my husband were faithful to me. It's interesting, isn't it? We were married 2 years, and there was this party, and this man's wife kept talking to Dawn about how she liked to shop in Midtown and how crummy all the hotels were, and she kept naming them until they agreed on a nice one. Then a few months later, we went to the Barclay for a drink, and he said, "I know the perfect spot." I jokingly said, "Really?" Then he coughed, the way he does when he lies. And he said, "I have a lot of meetings here." And I remember thinking, you would never meet with another man at the table where we sat. The way he makes love, sometimes it's what I want. Sometimes it's obviously what someone else wants. And I suppose that means I'm not enough. Maybe it's just him. Maybe it's just him.
bleached them too.
Perfectly white.
Amazing.
So, anything going on? Nope. So who knows? Who knows?
Wait, come on, it's me.
Okay.
Come on, we can talk about this. Let's come up with a plan, okay? I know you told Jimmy, but has it gotten back to Davis yet? Come on, Lee, just tell me what's going on and we can figure it out, okay?
Look, Grace, you're making me a little bit uncomfortable with how you're... Look,
Lee.
I just don't think it's any of your business.
Lee, baby, the words you're saying, there are incredible ramifications for those, and I know you know that.
I do know that. Thank you.
So let's do what's right here, okay?
Wow.
Well, you can't expect me to stand with you on this.
Okay. Don't.
You're playing with fire.
Is that what I'm doing?
You're making a mess.
I couldn't walk.
When?
When we got home. I couldn't walk.
You were drunk.
Okay.
Come on, Lee. Just don't do that. If you want to sleep around, look, that is your deal. And I praise you for having the courage. But the second that you start throwing around accusations, I'm going to raise my hand with questions.
I don't need you to go all pre-law student on
me, Well, how
Grace.
Do you expect me to react? Your sister's in the apartment babbling on about rape. What is going on? What happened at the party?
Why don't you tell me? It seems like you have a pretty good idea.
Yeah, I have an inkling. Yes.
You think I'm making it up? Are you pretending that you aren't? You know what? We're done.
What? You can't just pretend that you're done. You can't ignore this.
You and
it's
me,
not gonna go.
You and me, Grace.
What, you're gonna throw me out?
I would love for you to be my friend right now, but it seems you are unable to do that for me.
That's not how it looks to me.
So you came here to what? Help me with my lie? Is that it?
You just don't think about the position you're putting me in, do you?
This isn't about you, Grace. Just
be Grace. Just don't try and be this perfect example. Just be Grace. Just hold my hand and help me get through this. Just let me get through this. You really... don't believe me. Not even a shred of doubt.
I
You're
was there.
Sure. I was there, Lee.
Not the whole time.
I was listening.
Not the whole time.
God, why are you doing this? This is so fucked.
This is right.
But is it true?
What's the point?
I thought we were more than this, Lee.
We're not.
From me, Grace. I just want you to spread them wider next time, so that way the whole team can try and fit in.
No. You want me to confide in you and cry in your arms, and maybe I'll realize that the real person I love has been right here all along, so that you can say, I'm glad I paid her rent and took care of her. It was all fucking worth it.
And you want me to spread them wider so that you can fit in?
Well, I guess we know where we stand.
You know what? If you are telling the truth about all this, I hope it hurt.
this album, there's a picture of the ladies at Daniela's. You can tell it's from the 80s by the volume of their hair. There's Yusnavi, just a baby, 87, Halloween. If it happened on this block, Abuela was there. Every afternoon I came, she'd make sure I did my homework. She could barely write her name, but even so, she would stare at the paper and tell me, Bueno, let's review. Why don't you tell me everything you know?
My sister, we had a stomach flu, right? For a whole week, I mean, we couldn't keep nothing down, so my coworker, he took us to Children's Hospital, and they sent us home with a pamphlet, you know, bright blue paper, little cartoon diagrams. It said, give your kids a spoonful of water every 5 minutes. A small enough amount that they can keep it down, you know, 5 minutes, spoon, 5 minutes, spoon. And I remember thinking, like, wow, this is it, you know, family time, quality time, because it was just the three of us, and it was gentle, you know, the way you said, open up, and I'd open my mouth, and you'd put that little spoonful of water into my mouth, that little bit of relief, and then I'd watch you do the same thing with my little sister, and I remember being like, wow, I love you, Mom. Like, My mom's is all right, you know? 5 minutes, spoon, 5 minutes, spoon. And you. You couldn't just sit like that. You had to have your thing. And that's where I stopped remembering. 7 hours later, a neighbor comes and kicks in the door. Me and my sister are lying in a pile of laundry. My shorts was all messed up, and what I really don't remember is my sister. Quote, female infant, approximately 2 years old, pamper and tear ducts dry, likely cause of death, dehydration. 'Cause when you dehydrate, you can't form a single tear.
I knew who I was when they found me. I knew my family and friends would be worried, but I just wanted to fold up. Stop. Not have to think anymore. I was overwhelmed. I wasn't myself for almost a full day. But nobody else showed up to take the job, so I'm stuck with it. I'm sorry, this can't be very entertaining. There are people here with real problems. People just like me. I fell while I was running. I fell down, and I could see my hand and my sleeve. I could see a button on my sleeve, some dirt, an old acorn. And I thought to myself, if this is the last thing you're ever gonna see, I can live with that. I'm okay with that. I'm done. I've had enough. Because I'd already seen the worst. I just wanted it to stop, but it didn't. Stop. I kept seeing things. What do you have to change inside to survive? What do you do when the worst has already happened? Who do I have to become? I don't expect you guys to understand. You don't know me. I'm sorry, but it's true. You don't know me at all anymore. And you can't count on me.
Sleep where darkness falls.
dream your dreams, but don't pretend. Make friends with what you are. Give your heart, then change your mind. You're allowed to do it, 'cause God knows it's been done to you, and somehow you got through it. Alive in the age of worry, rage in the age of worry, sing out in the age of worry, and say, worry, why should I care? In the age of worry, act your age in the age of worry, and say, worry, get out of here. Ooh.
You have no understanding, do you? You have comprehended, just, that I am tired of being your mistress, and so your solution is to conscript me into becoming your wife. It is not being a mistress that I am tired of, John. I am tired of you. I do not wish to become your wife. I do not wish to become anyone's wife. I wish to continue as the creature that I am. I am no Nell Gwynn. I will not give up the stage as soon as a king or lord, having seen me upon it and wishing for me to be his and his alone, will pay a fortune to keep me off it. I am not the sparrow you picked up by the side of the road, my love. London walks into this theater to see me. Not George's play or Mr. Bitterton. Me. And when people desire you in such a manner, you can envision a steady stream of riches lapping at your doorstep. Not £5 here or there for pity or bed favors. Not a noble's ransom paid to keep you from the thing you love. But a lifetime of money amassed through your own endeavors. That is riches. You tell me to leave this gaudy gilded stage. It is gilded. It is gilded with my future earnings, and I will not give them up to become dependent on you. I will not trade my certain glory for your undependable love. Show. I have a show.
when you were here before. Couldn't look you in the eye. You're just like an angel. Your skin makes me cry. You float like a feather in a beautiful world. Yeah, I wish I was special. You're so fucking special. But I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't care if it hurts. I want to have control. I want a perfect body. I want a perfect soul. And I want you to notice when I'm not around. Yeah, I wish I was special. You're so fucking special. But I'm a I don't belong
See, I'm a stoner. That's why I went to jail. Because the signs were there. They had my house under observation for a year. They had my phones tapped. They had a helicopter. They had undercover DEA guys riding up in their bicycles. And you can tell they weren't bike riders, you know? Because bike riders have a look. They know how to act. These guys, like, don't know what they're doing. They have to jump off the bike to stop it. They come knocking at my door in their SWAT outfits at 5 in the morning. And the night before, like, we had been partying and someone's banging on my door. I mean, the door's always unlocked. We can never find the key. Stoners, man. Anyways, they come in their SWAT outfits, in their helmets, in their guns. And me being a stoner, like, I wasn't the least bit afraid. I wasn't scared. I'm not no criminal or dope dealer or anything like that. And I'm looking at these guys, and they're looking at me, and they look like trick-or-treaters. Oh, that's a nice costume there, Sonny. But I open the door, and they come barging in. And with this warrant to, like, search my house and computers and, like, shit. And I'm in my underwear. I forget I'm in my underwear. And I'm holding this warrant. Like, what? What is this? I couldn't figure it out. And the guy comes up to me, and he says, do you have any marijuana in the house? And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, well, where is it? And I'm like, every room in the house. And he's like, can you be more specific? And I'm like, yeah, you know, downstairs on the table, there's this blue Hawaiian, just got it, sativa, really nice. And so he sends a guy down there. And a few minutes later, the guy comes back up and he says, we can't find it. I'm like, what kind of fucking DEA guys are you? And get this, he gets defensive. And he's like, yeah, well, we don't have our dogs. Yeah, and that's another thing. Why don't you have your dogs? And my friend starts walking down the stairs. And I'm like, we're being busted. And he's like, for what? And I'm like, I don't know. So I asked the DEA guy, and he says, paraphernalia. I'm like, well, what's that? And he said, bongs. And I'm like, fuck, you're busting me for bongs? Really?